Hello, kids. Hi. Gay Spagetty is my name, and I'm here to celebrate Merry Christmas with you. I thought because it was Christmas, I would come down to the local children's hospital and share with you little sick children on Christmas my favorite Christmas movie ever. It's called Santa and Pete, and it is just wonderful. I think you're gonna love it, kids. It's really gonna cheer you up. It's a very good movie. It's very positive and uplifting and filled with positive, uplifting messages of goodness and happiness. It's very diverse and features everyone and everything. Everyone can enjoy this movie, even you kids. So what do you say? Where's the VCR, children? Where is it? Come on. We can't watch it without a VCR.
It's 2021, dipshit. We don't have VCRs. Only idiots like you still have VCRs.
Oh my. Such temper over there. Sorry, I didn't know. Maybe I'm behind the times a little bit. Okay, so screw it. We won't use a VCR. Maybe you could, oh, I know, Tubi TV has it. Do you have streaming here?
We did, but the internet's out, buddy.
Oh, the internet's out. What a shame. The internet is out. Well, you know what? A VCR doesn't need the internet.
Well, too bad, buddy. We don't have a VCR.
Oh, well, fine. No big deal. I'll just tell you the wonderful story myself then. And when you do get the internet back, kids, you can watch it for yourself and see what you think. It's great. You'll love it. You will. You'll all... It's adorable. It really is. So gather around, children. Gather around. You little Billy and Susie, gather around. Gay Spaghetti's gonna tell you the tale of Santa and Pete. First of all, what a title, kids, right? Santa and Pete. Doesn't it sound like two really close buddies? Yeah, Santa and Pete. This whole movie is told to you by James Earl Jones.
Well, I can't tell the story of Santa and Pete without starting with Santa. He came first, you know.
His grandson comes over with his mom, who's his daughter, of course, and they all sit around to celebrate Christmas. It's joyful and happy and, oh, it's wonderful. And James Earl Jones says, I'm gonna tell you the story of Pete. You're gonna love it, grandson. I tell it to everyone. And who wouldn't want to listen to a story being told to them by James Earl Jones? It's great, it's wonderful. So he goes off to tell them the story about, well, they all gather around. Gather around, everybody. James Earl Jones is talking. Now let me tell you at first, this is some TV movie. It came out in like 1999, and it stars, like I said, James Earl Jones, and Santa is played by an old man actor whose name is Hume Cronin. And if you know anything about movies, you'll know Hume Cronin was in Cocoon, Cocoon 2, he was in Batteries Not Included, he was in a lot of stuff. He was married to Jessica Tandy. And this is like gotta be one of his last performances because he was like so old then. And then he just died at one point. Probably after this. Probably, this could have been his last movie. I don't think it was, but anyway, let's get on. I'm rambling about Hume Cronin. He was a cute little guy. I mean, come on, Hume. Who has a name like that? Nobody names their kids Hume anymore. Anyway, let's get to the story. It flashes back to like the 1800s when Santa is going to Spain, spreading his little Santa messages to everybody. And I guess Spain at that time was like at war with the Moors or something. And Santa gets picked up because he's like a weirdo. And they take him into this prison, and they like interrogate him, and they find this book on him called The Book of Life, which is like Santa's list of names and shit, and he like checks people's names off, and they think he's a weirdo for this. This old crazy guy carries around a bag of candy and toys and all sorts of weird stuff, and he's just like giving them to kids and spreading happiness. What a freaking weirdie, right? So they put him in jail for this, right? And then he's in jail, and that same night, one of the servants at the jail comes down, like, give him food and water and stuff, and guess who it is? It's Pete! Pete! And then they talk, like, all night. Pete's a real nice guy, too. He's like, what the heck are you doing working in a prison? So Pete is black, and Santa's white. So, like I said, it's such a diverse movie.
To look at them, you might have focused on their differences. One was black, the other white. One was a cook, the other a bishop.
So that they become like best buddies in one night. Such best buddies that Pete's like hell with this, Santa. Santa shouldn't be in jail. I'm gonna bust your ass out of jail. So that's what he does.
Would you like to come with me? I can use a partner. Me? I'm just a cook.
You're much more than that.
Which means, uh-oh, now they gotta go on a run together. But, you know, they really don't have to run. They just get out of jail and then they're fine. They just go back doing Santa stuff. It's just Santa and Pete going around giving kids toys and candy. And yeah, they might seem like weirdos, but they're harmless. And Santa's like old as hell. He's like super old. They never explain why Santa is immortal. And they never explain why he has all these powers. He like knows stuff about people. He knows what they want and need. He's this wonderful old man. He really is. He's sweet. And Pete's like the best guy to be with him. They're a great team.
We're now coming to our favorite part.
Which part?
Where they come to the new world.
So anyway, they go to the new world. That's right. They get on a boat and they go to the new world, which, you know, it's America. It's what we're at now, the United States. Anyway, this movie sort of depicts America as not so racist at all. They don't even say the word slavery. You don't even see a slave. They actually hang out with a black family in this. They have their own little house. In a little place, they call it, in the outskirts of New Amsterdam, called Harlem. It's a little place called Harlem. We have a nice little cabin. You should come over sometime. And they do, and they'll hang out, have a little Merry Christmas. And one of the ladies, the mother of the house, is played by Tempest Bledsoe. And if you don't know who Tempest Bledsoe is, kids, you probably don't. It's a little before your time, but The Cosby Show. She played the daughter, Vanessa. Yeah, anyway. You kids don't know The Cosby Show. Okay, that's not a big deal. So anyway, like I said, they're painting a very nice version of America back then. They're being real nice to them because, you know, there was a lot more racism back then, but they don't show like any of that. Like everybody's sort of nice to everybody because Santa's going around being all like nice and giving kids stuff. And he even goes to the mayor of Amsterdam. Santa goes to the mayor of Amsterdam, who's like sort of an arrogant dick, and says, you gotta like make peace with the Indians. And like in a peaceful way, not go make war with them and stuff. So Santa's like, I'll take care of this shit. I'll take care of it, I'll go out there, I'll make fucking peace with the Indians. You don't need to like shoot each other, you don't need to go nuts. So Santa's like this peace-loving guy. I mean, right? More good messaging, right? So he's like, I'm gonna ride right out there and talk to the Indians. You think, well, that's crazy, right? You can go out there and be like, oh, hi, I'm Santa. And then what are they gonna do? Shoot him in the head with an arrow, right? No, he goes out there and they're like, hey, Santa, get the hell over here. Yeah, they like knew he was coming, right? Turns out that the Indians also had a weird prophecy about Santa Claus. That one day this old white guy with a beard would show up or something. Big white bearded man would show up and spread good, peaceful stuff. And he did. And the Indians were like, hey, buddy, we like you.
It is the man with the white beard. We have waited a long time for your return.
I'm sorry, sir, but I think you may have mistaken me for someone else.
Come, join us.
We liked Santa. The Indians were like real buddy-buddy with Santa immediately like that. Like, they knew who the hell he was. They knew he was Santa. So you're like, come on in, hang out with us. And they did. They even gave Santa his big famous red coat.
It took two full moons to find the reddest of berries to dye this coat. This is perfect.
That's how it happened, kids. Indians gave Santa that red coat that he always wears. Uh-huh, that's how it happened. Mm-hmm, that's how it really happened, kids. I think some of the coolest parts of this movie is how they show the evolution of Santa's outfit. That was kind of neat. So if you're really curious at how Santa's outfit came to be, this is the movie for you. They show where he got his sled, they show how it flies, and then sort of, and then he takes off in the end. It's spectacular. The effects are, you know, about what you'd expect for a TV movie. They spread love, forgiveness, friendship, and show you how to have a playful sense of humor. It's good, kids. It really is. It's a good thing. It's a happy thing. You'll love this movie. It's so family friendly and joyful and peaceful and happy. I love it. I love it. It's just joyful. And James Earl Jones, oh my god, I love James Earl Jones. And to be even extra diverse, the whole legend supposedly comes from the Dutch. Everyone's represented. It's a beautiful movie that really tries to touch and be all diverse and equal and all the cultures brought into one. And that's basically it, kids. The story of Santa and Pete. I just loved it. I thought it was adorable. And I know you will, too. And if you ever get a VCR around here, here it is. I'll leave it here for you. But you probably will get the internet back before you do that, so you can just watch it on Tubi. It's delightful. It really is. Santa and Pete sort of had like this Django and Dr. Schultz relationship, if you've ever seen Django Unchained. Only far less, far less violent, bloody, and racist. But still, it sort of reminded me of that. And to say something for Pete reminds me of Dave Chappelle in Robin Hood Men in Tights. Remember him in that movie? He liked that. He sort of reminds me of that. It's like Santa and Dave Chappelle in Robin Hood Men in Tights. Hanging out, spreading peace, goodwill, and Santa's wonderful message of love and happiness and equality for everyone. Which is a good thing, actually, right? It really is, children. Think about it. Everybody being equal? How is that a bad thing? Anyway, that's it, kids. I really gotta go now. Christmas shopping. Wild, kids. Wild. Now, wasn't that story fabulous? Merry Christmas and get well soon, you little scamps. Merry Christmas to all and to all a good night. Gay Spaghetti out. Bye. Since you probably won't need this, I'll just take it with me. You know, Hollywood Video would be pissed if I brought it back late. God. Bye, kids.
Slow spaghetti, and Merry Christmas to you.
Nice slow spaghetti.
Huh? Good night, Steve, and Steve too. Good night.
How adorable over there. How cute. Merry Christmas. Hi, kitty. Merry Christmas, kitty.
Good thing you're comfortable on the floor. We ain't got a fucking bed for you.
Aw, so soft.